What was demand like before SB8?
Before, I might, in a day of doing consultations, I might schedule 45 patients. Now I'm scheduling 15.
Wow.
Yeah.
It wasn't easy to access abortion services in Texas even before SB8.
You know, I've been in Texas for 8 years, and it has never been easy to have an abortion here. There's the 24-hour waiting period. There's the rules on who can do an ultrasound. It has to be done by the same physician who is going to be performing your abortion. If for some reason you can't come back on a day that that physician is there, but you can see another physician, you have to have another ultrasound, and then your 24-hour waiting period starts all over again.
I think a lot of people don't realize that all those provisions still apply. It's just now you have to meet all of them after you realize you're pregnant and before a heartbeat shows up on the ultrasound. Yes.
It is burden on top of burden, and that impacts the most vulnerable people. It's women of color, people who are underemployed, who don't have access to money, adequate time off.
Do you remember those early conversations where you had to tell patients, you no longer can have an abortion because of a new law that just passed the Texas legislature that was upheld effectively by the Supreme Court?
Yeah. You know, the first patient who I saw after the law went into effect, when I told her that we could see cardiac activity, you know, she just curled up into a ball on the table and just started sobbing. And she asked if she could hold my hand.
Yeah.
And that was all I could do for her in that moment.
Do you remember what her story was?
You know, she was a college student, had a birth control failure. You know, she was a person who wasn't in a situation where she could be pregnant. Women in Texas have been punished legislative session after legislative session. These are people you know who are getting turned away, and this could be you next.